You've probably seen videos where people put a drop of water into a hot pan, and instead of it evaporating, it forms into a ball and dances around. This is called the Leidenfrost effect, and it's the key to preventing foods like eggs from sticking to stainless steel pans. Many people talk about this, but nobody actually knows what temperature the pan needs to be for the Leidenfrost effect to happen. And when you look online, you get a wide range of answers. To get to the bottom of it, I conducted tests with three different stainless steel pans using a surface thermometer, a water dropper, and a bowl of room temperature tap water. For the first test, I used the Heritage Steel Eater Series 12-inch frying pan. I set it on the stove, turned the heat to medium, and let it warm up. I put the first drop of water in the pan at around 240 degrees Fahrenheit, and it slowly evaporated. The pan wasn't even close to ready. At 275 degrees, it evaporated much quicker, but it still wasn't ready. The same thing happened as I tested it all the way up to 390 degrees. At 400 degrees, the water balled up briefly at the center of the pan, but evaporated when it flowed to the sides. This continued at 410 and 417, although the balls of water lasted slightly longer as the pan got hotter. At 430 degrees, I noticed something interesting. When I dropped the water in the pan, it bounced around until it landed on a spot where water previously evaporated. Most likely, that spot was cooler than the rest of the pan, and this temperature difference broke the vapor layer under the water droplet. Finally, the Leidenfrost effect was fully achieved when the pan reached 450 degrees Fahrenheit at the center. The water balled up, danced around the pan, and maintained its form even when crossing over areas where previous droplets evaporated. The ball of water even got stuck to the thermometer, and when I lifted it up, it remained intact. To validate these results, I conducted the same test with the all-clad D3 12-inch frying pan. At 370 degrees, the water balled up for a second, but quickly evaporated as it moved to the sides. The same thing happened at 390 degrees. At 400 degrees, the water droplets lasted a little bit longer, but still evaporated. At 430 degrees Fahrenheit, the all-clad pan did the same thing as the Heritage Steel pan. Water droplets bounced around until they hit a spot where previous droplets fizzled out. Instead of waiting for the pan to get hotter, I tilted it so the droplet could avoid the cooler spots. When I did that, the vapor layer persisted and the water danced around the pan. I wanted to see if the thickness of the pan mattered, so I tested it one more time with the thickest stainless steel pan I own, the Demeyer Atlantis Proline skillet. Like the other pans, the water started to ball up around 400 degrees, but still evaporated when it moved to the sides of the pan. When the center of the pan reached 430 degrees, the Leidenfrost effect was fully triggered. Water droplets maintained their shape and gracefully danced around the entire surface without evaporating. One of my main takeaways from these tests is that the entire cooking surface needs to be above a certain temperature for the Leidenfrost effect to occur consistently. When the outer edges of the cooking surface aren't as hot as the center, the water will evaporate. Cool spots like the ones I caused by repeatedly dropping water into the pan also have an impact. So after watching the tests over and over again, and with the considerations I just mentioned, I believe in the context of stainless steel cookware, the Leidenfrost effect begins around 420 degrees Fahrenheit or 215 degrees Celsius. But if you're measuring from the center of the pan, aim for approximately 430 degrees Fahrenheit or 221 degrees Celsius to ensure the entire pan is hot enough. The exact temperatures might vary by the temperature of your water, the size of your pan, the type of burner you're using, and the heat setting on your stove. But the test that I just conducted will give you a good target to aim for. If you want to know how the Leidenfrost effect can help you cook eggs in a stainless steel pan without sticking or burning, check out this video. And for more tips like this, click the logo to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.